Tonight, we honor as our guest speaker a very special individual. But we don't only honor him for his generosity and his philanthropy. We honor the fulfillment of a vision of the Rebbe, the fulfillment of a vision which began many, many years ago. The Rebbe used to say that Russian Jewry is the life mission of the previous Rebbe. And long before the Iron Curtain fell, the Rebbe would send shluchim in the underground to teach Torah, to perform brisin, to perform marriages, and to keep alive the spark of Judaism in the former Soviet Union. This paved the way for what is today one of the most revolutionary aspects of Torah life, of Jewish life. One such individual is our guest speaker, our guest of honor tonight. As you will hear, he was born in a town called Dnepr-Dzhinsk, moved to the Rebbe's hometown of Yekaterinoslav. At that period of time when he was growing up, there were 13 people who were not afraid to sign their names that they are Jewish for fear of retribution by the communist regime. One of those 13 was our guest of honor's grandmother. Yekaterinoslav is a city of 50,000 Jews. Today boasts 60 shluchim amongst the 450 shluchim that are in the former Soviet Union. There's being built there the menorah center, which our guest of honor has undertaken as his project, which is 50,000 square meters, which will be the largest Jewish community center in the world. But to shluchim, he has a very personal connection. For he established a fund, amongst his many other tzedakas, which shares in the personal simchas of each and every shliach, a serious participation in a shliach's wedding, in a bar mitzvah, and a birth. And just recently, when he was merited that he enjoyed the birth of his own baby daughter, he included the shluchim in his personal simcha by sending each shliach a check for yontif so that they should be able to spend yontif in a beautiful and spiritual manner. Please give your attention to the screens just for one moment.
At any given moment, there's a simcha of a shliach taking place somewhere in the world. A young shliach is born. A bar mitzvah is celebrated. A wedding ceremony takes place. In another part of the world, one unique individual has made an unprecedented move to share in the personal simchas of every shliach. Born in 1961 in the city of Dnepr-Dzhinsk, Ukraine, Mr. Tzvi Hirsch Bogolubov has always been a proud Jew. After graduating high school, he moved to Dnipropetrovsk, the Rebbe's hometown, where he continues to play a pivotal role in its flourishing Jewish community. But for Mr. Bogolubov, that was not enough. 3 years ago, he established a fund to support the personal simchas of every shliach across the globe, bringing joy and delight to the family of shluchim everywhere, and to their extended families, the communities which they serve. The family of shluchim joins together in expressing our appreciation to Mr. Tzvi Hirsch Bogolubov for all he has done and continues to do for shluchim and the Jewish community the world over.
Mr. Bogolubov is here today with his shliach, Rabbi Shmuel Kamenetsky, who is sitting in the seat of rabbinic leadership of the Rebbe's father. Everyone in the world was always used to raising money for Soviet Jewry. It is remarkable how from the Rebbe's city comes such beautiful care and concern for shluchim around the world. We salute Rabbi Kamenetsky, and let us all put our hands together and welcome our guest speaker, Rabbi Tzvi Hirsch Gennady Bogolubov.
Dear Shluchim of the Rebbe, dear guest, till the last minutes I wouldn't believe I would stand on this platform, and I tell you why. Like a few months ago, my dear friend Reb Moshe Kotlyarsky asked me to speak on the Kinus HaShluchim, and I immediately refused because of the few reasons. First of all, it's not my type of event. Second, I am not a great speaker. Third, he asked me to speak in English, which is not my mother tongue. I think in Russian, I have to translate every word. I asked him permission. I said to him, if you want me to be a partner on the Kinus, let me pay for everything. And you see, how did I end up? I pay and I'm here. This is the power of Chabad. This is what they teach you in all of your workshops, seminars, etc., how to treat the supporters. No, really. If you check my heart rate now, my fitness trainer would be proud because I cannot achieve it in a gym. I am really worried. And he took an ally, Rabbi of Dnipropetrovsk, Reb Shmuel Kamenetsky, they make for me. They make me forehand massage, you know, like to encourage me to come here. They even wrote me the speech. I have beautiful speech here. I take it with me. I take my glasses because if I would not be able to say the word, I could read. At least I could read. But after a bit l'chaim, you know, I relax a little bit. Maybe it's a good speech. It's a good speech to be published on COL or any other newspaper. It's Lichvot, Chabad Lubavitch movement, Dnipropetrovsk Jewish community, Reb Moshe Katlarsky, Reb Shmuel Kamenetsky. But it's not me, it's not my speech. I read it, it's not me. If you want to understand who am I have to speak differently. And before I start, I want to, because you see the energy, what I see here, the 5,000 people in one space, one venue, it's unbelievable energy. So I feel it, really I feel it, and because we already, you and each of you, me and each of you, few times made a L'chaim remotely by correspondence, I want face to face, me and you, everyone, make a L'chaim for your simcha and my simcha. Because I am someone who fulfilled the account to be able, Reb Moshe, to check you, to send you a checks. L'chaim, l'chaim. I have something, substitution here. Unfortunately, I forget to ask me. Ah, they bring him now. L'chaim, l'chaim. Thank you very much. I wish we would have a lot of simchot. And you know, when he called me and sent the money finished, you have to send more, I feel so big happiness, so uplift feeling, like one more child born, one more Bochrim turned so 13. Two more people get married. L'chaim, l'chaim. So I thought, what subject could I speak with you? I cannot tell you Dvar Torah, because the small boy, what he was before me, knows more than me. I cannot do any pilpul about halakha with you, because I am so down to the earth. I can just tell you a few stories about my life. And you know, my life was not so dramatic like I read in the book about refusnik, about people who was in gulag or prison because of the Judaism. I really born in Dnipro-Dzerzhinsk, which is, for people who doesn't speak Russian, it's very difficult even to pronounce. It's a small city in the east of Ukraine, very, very industrial. I born in a normal family, and my father and mother, they work hard to be, let's say, able to feed the children. And what did I know about Judaism? Nothing. Only a few. Because everyone has a like a Yontef, like a holidays, like May Day, Revolution Day. And we had also with everyone. And I had a bit on top, like my grandmother. The parents dressed me in a white shirt and took me to my grandfather. And it was a Yontef, which in that time I didn't understand, but they call it Pesach, because we had the matzalach, we had the chopped herrings, the adults had some glass of vodka, so I didn't understand. Everyone playing in the ground, and I had to be in my grandmother's place. Another grandmother used to live with us in our apartment, and she wasn't well. And for many years, she did not went out of the apartment. But once a year, she didn't eat. It was Yom Kippur. She passed away 20 years ago, but if I would meet her now, maybe not the first question, but second question I would ask, how did she know the date? Because she has no friend, she has no connection with the wall, just TV, Soviet TV, which never said about the Yom Kippur or any other date. I was big atheist. It means I was a pioneer, I was Komsomol member. I haven't been a communist member, but because, you know, they didn't let me. I tried, but they didn't let me. My father always told me, you have to make your career. You have to become this and this and this, because you have to establish yourself in your life. So when I was, you know, 25 years of my life, it was nothing with the Judaism. But after Perestroika, when the business come to Soviet Union, I realized there is more Jews in the city. Because if you do a business, you can meet more and more Jewish people, because, you know, they do a macher, just a macher. Everyone, I cannot say the business was only Jewish business, but a lot of Jewish people was in the business. That is why I understand the Jewish people, I am Jewish, etc., etc. And I remember the year 1995. We already had a quite big business, we already had a bank. The Ukraine was an independent country. And our city got changed because we started to see the strange people on the street. I remember I drove my car and I see someone, I don't know whether it was Kamenetsky or someone else, but I see someone who looks different than any other pedestrians. They walk. And my partner once came to me and said, look, we have a rabbi in the house, in the city, and he invites us for dinner. Shall we go? I said, okay, but what we can find there? To find the food, we have a lot of food. To find the relationship, so whether we need it. And I refused, we didn't go. Few weeks after, he came to me again and said, big friend of mine, he said, it's not only food, it's not only a relationship, it's a good person. And we decided to go. It was a big discussion whether we go with family or without. With family or without. I said, let's go first without, because I don't know what they will do with us. Maybe it will be some special program. Let's try. And we came. This was my first time, 1995, April. I met my rabbi, my great friend, Reb Shmuel Kamenetsky. I don't remember what did we talk about during the dinner, but next day he invited me to the shul, to the synagogue, which I've never been before. I come, it was very old building, before revolution, built before revolution, and it was like a few people who tried to keep it and protect it from the Soviet Union invasion, and, you know, they write a letter to Rebbe to send the shliach. And I come to synagogue, I expect to see something like spiritual, like I saw in the movie, like, you know, but I see a lot of movement, a lot of people go around. But what impressed me most than others, it's the soup kitchens behind. It was very bad kept soup kitchen, like very, very simple style. And maybe 20 people sit and eat simple food. I ask, what is this? He said, anyone who wants to eat can come and we give him. My question was, but how do you know they really need? Maybe they have enough money, enough food at home, but just want to challenge you, just want to eat for free. He looked at me seriously and he asked me a question which changed my life. Can you come and ask for food? I said, no. He said, if someone come and ask, he really needs. This changed my life. Next day I come to the shul. He explained me the program, like a summer camp, this and that. I don't remember the description. But next day I come to shul and give him $10,000. After that, I gave out the millions. And everything I can explain, why did I do that? Everything I can say besides that $10,000. Because if we turn time back and I have to do it again, I'm 100% sure I would give everything again and again and again besides the $10,000. Because it was unexplainable. Because in that time, our business means we have to go and take and put in the pocket. But to do the reverse, backward, it was against the nature. I did it and it changed my life. I would be not person who appreciate, who are thankful, if I would not appreciate the God to put on my way the people, special people, like Reb Shmuel Kamenetsky. And I want to mention specially Reb Levi Levayev. See, Reb Moshe Kotlyarsky gave me only 20 minutes, already 10 past. You know, if you want to listen to the story, you should be patient because I cannot finish. So I don't like if someone teach me, you know, but I'd like to study. Reb Levi Levayev never teach me. He give me an example. He come to Dnipropetrovsk 1997 to open Beit Hana, named for his mother. And for us, it was like a someone come from the moon, like a rich man from the Forbes, etc., etc., from Israel, to come to give. And the delegation of Dnipropetrovsk meet him at the airport, follows from one building to another. For me, and he didn't say much, you know him, he never talked much. For me, he never teach me, but I study from him. I study from him how to give. He told me once. He told me once something which I read now in the holy books. He told me mitzvah goreret mitzvah. The reward for mitzvah is mitzvah itself. So now I know it. I thanks to God, I meet on my life way Reb Moshe Kotlyarsky. This is really special person. And I met him many years ago, also with the help of my friend Reb Levi Levayev. It was this big event in Israel, like Kinus Ashluchim for Soviet Union. And they introduced me to him. He didn't know in that time I can be here this now and pay for kinus, but he was very kind of me. And I really admire this person because I watch his life. It's something special. For me, I'm very material person, you know, I follow the logic like a woman, you know, I want to understand if I come from here, if I go there, I want to understand what it will be in the end. But the life to be sacrificed in the name of Hashem, name of Rebbe, for me it's something special. Simcha Fund. It's interesting story how we come to the Simcha Fund project. In 2007, I have some problem in my personal life. I was very down. And once I come to Kamenetsky house and I said, you know, I don't know what to do because this bad, I have very bad mood. It's not like I don't want to live anymore, but I need something which helped me to survive with the circumstances. And he said, don't worry, why you don't write the letter to the Rebbe? 2007, what does it mean to write letter to the Rebbe? For me, material person. He said, we have some minhag, you know, we write a letter to put in the book, and you will get the answer. So I write the letter. I wrote the letter, which I describe all of my problems. Family situation, business situation, children, this and that. It was 3 pages. He said, okay, choose the book. I choose the book, put inside. I put inside. And said, now we have to make a lechaim. We make a lechaim. I wake up in the morning, you know, I forget about everything we did before. But in the morning, when I come to my office, it was a translation of 3 letters. Because the page, what I put, it was 3 letters. I tell you a secret now, which I never tell to anyone before. One was addressed to someone who has a problem with the health. Please be aware and take care about your health. It's not to me, yet. Second, about Lashon Hara. It's very much to me. And third one, it was like this. I am very happy to hear you help your community. But now I want to hear you help Akol Chabad. It was April 2007. I forget to be, I'm afraid to be mistaken, August or September, it was a wedding of one of the children of Levi Levayev. I met Reb Moshe Kotlyarsky on the wedding. In that time, business was above the roof. It was golden rain. I was in very good mood. And I said to him, I want to give you $10 million. Just like this. He looked at me without any, you know, any emotion and said, what is the project? I said, no project, just to, you can do whatever you want. And I see the emotion because I understood he has much bigger supporters than I am, but everyone wants to have a project. And, you know, I didn't have a project. I just give him money. And what was his biggest achievement? Biggest step for my understanding, he said, okay, 50-50. I will take 5 million for the budget to help the shluchim with their, for their needs. And the half of the money, I want to make a project for you. It means for me. And like this, born in Simcha Fund. Now I can tell you the project is beautiful because every quarter I receive albums. It's three colors of albums. One color, it's like a light brown color for the newborn. And when I open, I see the picture of your newborn with a letter addressed to me, Mr. Bogolubov, thank you very much. It's a beautiful. Another color, it's a green color for someone who turns 13 for bar mitzvah. Beautiful Bohrim face, who already with a Chabad Lubavitch Barcelona head. And the blue one was a beautiful couple. I already start to make a research because the couple who was married 2 years ago now already have a children. So I try to find the name. Maybe in 10 years, I will see the boys with a name who got a check from Mr. Bogolubov, you know, like this. In 20 years, I want to find someone who got a check when he was born and get married. Maybe when I get retired, I will make a big agency to, you know, how to connect people, because I will have a database the biggest in the world. And Baruch Hashem, he come to me to approach me, they bother me with the money to fill up the fund, often. It means you work good, you don't sleep, and Simcha by Simcha by Simcha, together with me, I want to celebrate. I see Reb Moshe Katlyarsky already make for me the scary face. Maybe I'm out of time, but okay, he allow me five more minutes if you allow me. I cannot go out without mentioning Dnipropetrovsk Jewish community. Because it's something, it's a creature, unbelievable entity, which I grew up in. Because it was nothing. It's very difficult to explain the people who never live in Soviet Union, who never understand the Soviet Union mentality. If you come now to Dnipropetrovsk, you understand it's not only to be easy to be a Jew in Dnipropetrovsk. It's a pleasure to be Jew in Dnipropetrovsk. It's a big honor to be Jew in Dnipropetrovsk. We built the biggest Jewish center in the world. You know, my biggest achievement when I start to put tefillin on, when I start to say Shema Israel, when I start to keep kashrut, my biggest achievement, I start to see Ashgaha Pratit. I remember the time and the date and the destination. I flew on 10,000 meters on my private jet, and I think about to build something memorable for Jewish people in Ukraine. But I thought it should be a capital of the country. I decided to buy a piece of land in Kyiv and to build a beautiful building which will be memory about my existence in the earth. First of all, I didn't found any land in Kyiv. I cannot build anything in Kyiv. But all of a sudden, idea come to, for me to build Dnipropetrovsk. What is Ashgaha Pratit? Dnipropetrovsk is the capital of Jewish people in Ukraine. So So menorah center, it's the same, it's a seven towers. Each one has a light on top. And the idea to light it like Yom Rishon, it is one building, Yom Sheni, it's two, etc., etc., Shabbat, the whole seven. So all of the plane go from Europe to the East, we'll see seven lights. We build menorah hall. Menorah hall, it's a event center, which in one time can eat 1,700 people. Unfortunately, with the speed which organization grow, we cannot receive a kinus ashluchim, but maybe smaller event we can be host of. My life changed very much. Something which I really didn't think about before, like I go out from synagogue, I'm shy to have a kippah on my head. Now I have tzitzis. The reason I have it, because my son Baruch had an obshernish, and Ramosha Katlarsky came for the event and brought two tzitzis for him and for me. And for me, it's very difficult to tell him, like the man in a house who over 3 years old has to wear the tzitzis without doing it. So I start also to do it. I have synagogue in my house in London. I have Sunday Jewish school for kids. And I'm ready to do many more. And if you ask me why, I cannot answer. Because this last year, I was in Israel on Shavuot, and we have a beautiful company of Russian Jewish people, and you know, they invite the big Talmid Chacham just to be with us, to give us some shiurim. It was misnugget like this, you know, very. And we sit on the table, and he makes something like, you know, the question and answer. Like, what's the trigger point for each of you to start Keep Shabbos? And everyone answered, you know, I met a friend, I married the wife, I come to the situation, etc., etc. When it was my turn, to be frank, I didn't want to tell. I said it was a mess. It was a miracle. Because I cannot find any reason in this world to explain why did I start to keep Shabbos. So Reb Moshe already nervous. I am not anymore. So I want to finish. I want to finish now, but I want to thank the people who Hashem sent to my way. I already mentioned Reb Shmuel Kamenetsky, Reb Levi Levayev, Reb Moshe Katlarsky, Chief Shaliach from Austria, Reb Yaakov Biderman. Reb Shaya Boaz, who give me shiurim and give me appetite to study Hasidut, Kabbalah, Tanya, Torah. Reb Pinchas Altois, which he doesn't understand me, I don't understand him, but we love each other so much, it's a body language. And I want to thank all of you, because if not you, I would not be able to execute my right to do a mitzvah. Thank you very much, you are with me. You nominate me as a partner. and it's the maximum what you can do for me. The next step is my step. Next time I have to come to you and say, I don't want to be a partner anymore, I want to be a part. Thank you very much again. And I expect from you more requests for checks.